Here's a look at next week's matchups. Join the Miniature Car Racing Facebook group to become a driver. I dare you to say that three times fast. Here's a look at next week's matchups. Here's a look at next week's matchups. Here's a look at next week's matchups. It's not that easy. That's why I get paid the big bucks. Welcome to the Miniature Car Racing Weekly Tournament. I'm your host, Wes Coulson. All right, enough chit-chat. In the first lane, driving a 2018 SRT Demon Landshark. In lane two, driving a 2023 Nissan Z, Gabe Real. In lane three, driving the Diesel Boy with Hefe Customs, you have Hefe. And in lane four, driving the Volvo P1800 Gasser, Van the Man. Hefe and Van the Man start to separate. Hefe, Van the Man, Gabriel, and Landshark looking like a beach whale. Van the Man with the early lead. Hefe blows by. Ice in the track. Gabriel takes second while Hefe's trying to figure out what happened. And Landshark puts some points on the board. Hefe jumps out, has his eyes set on the second round. With Gabriel, first time driver. Just trying to make a run for it. Compete with the big dogs. Van the Man takes command and lead in second with that DNF by Gabriel. Final race. Let's go. Hefe and the Diesel Boy are looking good. But Gabriel needs to capture second and DNF from Van the Man. Hefe with a perfect run. Van Man edges out Gabriel. In lane one, driving the 95 RX-7 Cloud. In lane two, driving the Sweet 16 Triple B. Driving the Honda S2000 in lane three, Lightman. And in lane four, driving the Mazda Rep, your co-commissioner and head of track design, Bolo Brown. Cloud with the lead is all business. Bolo Brown taking second. Triple B with third. Lightman putting points on the board. McLeod wants no part of the scrum and separates from the pack. Triple B's in distant second. Lightman catches Bolo with the horseshoe. And Bolo reclaims third at the finish line. Cloud starting to flex. The Triple B, Shredder Speedway, wants all the smoke. And Lightman chokes on sex. McLeod pretty much has this wrapped up. Fight's going between Triple B and Bolo for second. And Triple B has the lead coming off the kiss. Bolo catches him off the horseshoe. Blows by. That should do it. Overtime. McLeod is being trailed by Triple B. Now Bolo passes Triple B. Triple B passes Bolo back. Bolo once again.
Wait, who's that in the distance? Gotta respect it. Put points on the board.
Triple B and Bolo get the fans what they want. In lane one, driving the Dodge Challenger sprint car, John Seaver. In lane two, driving the Super Stinger, Storm Trooper, son. In lane three, driving the 1970 Pontiac Firebird, the Return of Malice Foul. And in lane four, driving the Pocket Bikester, the B-Man. A lot of back and forth. And the B-Man emerges. John Receiver's on his bumper. V-Man. Hold on. Van the Man, V-Man. Have we confirmed this ain't the same dude? John Receiver comes out the gates hot. V-Man takes the lead. But wait. Malice Foul hits the nitro. Security, stay on your toes. Anyone have eyes on Van the Man? I repeat. Looks like synchronized driving. I don't know who's winning. John Receiver, Storm Trooperson, and the B-Man little brother's Malice Mouth for third. Nothing to see at the top. All the action's at the bottom. 2 points separate second and fourth. And it's the V-Man and Stormtroopers are going head-to-head for the final spot. John Receiver and the V-Man moving on. In lane one, driving the Barbie Dream Camper, Jonathan Hammer. Lane two, driving the 71 Datsun 510 wagon, King Sharp. In lane three, driving the 67 Camaro, Chef. And in lane four, driving the Color Change Scion XB, Mark Taylor. Woo! Mark got that Scion floating across the track. And Jonathan Hammer's pushing the struggle bus. King Shark and Mark Taylor neck and neck. Struggle bus keeping pace. I spoke too soon, struggle bus. King Shark with the big lead. King Shark, Mark Taylor, Jonathan Hammer. And Chef better whip us up one of those CDR recipes. King Shark taking him into deep waters. Mako racing. Where's Chef at? We're going to have to talk to the scout team. I know we saved the fish on the track. We're going to race it. But can we get some cars that can make it all the way down the track? History's made. Chef gets the first donut in MCR history. Jonathan Hammer gets the jump. The Hefe comes up the turn like a boss. Mark Taylor catches him on the kiss, blows by. And Jonathan Hammer returns the favor to Hefe on the final turn. Hefe takes the high road, but Jonathan Hammer gets low. All three drivers are tied at the horseshoe. Hefe edges out Bolo for second. Bolo Brown with some ground to make up has the lead. Hefe tries to bang him from the back, and Bolo's having none of that. All four drivers are in this thing. Final race. Jonathan Hammer takes the high road, but this time it's Hefe that gets low. It's going to be a fight for second. This turned out to be a dogfight. Hefe and Jonathan Hammer moving on to the finals. The moment I've been waiting for. V-Man versus Pan the Man. There's levels to this. King Shark takes first, McCloud second, the V-Man third, and Pan the Man fourth. King Shark picking up where he left off, but McCloud has other plans. The V-Man jumps in the battle for second. King Shark holds off the V-Man for second. It's tied with McCloud for first. King Shark looking to swing the tide back his way. But McCloud is doing what he wants to do out there. Looks like this heat is wrapped up. McCloud and King Shark moving on to the final. So let me take the time to say, come to Dodge Race. Gourmet fast food. All sauces made from scratch. Everybody needs a wing, man. Hefe and McCloud swept through the first round, but had all they could handle in the second round. Let's see who's going to step up and take the title. King Shark and McCloud picking up where they left off, doing battle like two sworn enemies. All three drivers get the jump on McCloud. And then he methodically picks this track apart. Everybody playing musical chairs. McCloud has a nice point, so he's at the halfway marker. Hefe gets rocked. Jonathan Hammer making a final push for the title. Takes first. McCloud is one race away from bringing the title back to Caledonia Diecast Raceway. McCloud comes off the horse and went to the kids looking to close this out. But King Shark has other plans. McCloud catches Hefe at the gate for second. If Jonathan Hammer would have took second, we'd be going to overtime right now. But that's the way the cookie crumbles. Your week two champion is McCloud.